Hare Krishna. The Gita is not insightful. It is inciteful. To incite someone means to provoke them, to emotionally agitate them, to goad them into taking some violent action. And some people, on seeing the setting of the Gita, may think that actually the Gita is a book like that. It is insightful because Arjun at the start of the Gita had become reluctant to fight and he had just decided, Visvrujya Sasharam Japam Shokasam Vignamanasaha. He put aside his bow saying, I will not fight. But by the end of the Gita, he became ready to fight. He lifted up his bow and he was ready to fight. Yatra Partho Dhanurdhara, as I described in 18.78. So now, on seeing that a warrior who was not ready to fight became ready to fight, somebody might think that the Gita incited him. But actually, there is no hate speech in the Gita at all. The Gita, in fact, doesn't even mention once the atrocities that were performed against the Pandavas, which would have incited Arjuna to fight. The name of Draupadi, who was repeatedly insulted, it comes only when referring to her son who was on the war field. So Krishna does not speak a single inciting word in the Gita. The whole Gita actually is insightful. It's filled with insights. What is the insight? The inner sight. The sight within is the sight of our inner world and the sight of others' inner world. And what it does is, it enables us to fight based on that inner sight. So, for example, in 3.30 it is said, Mai sarvani karmani sannyasya adhyatma chetasa nirashir nirmamo buddhva yudhyasva vigata jvaraha. This is fight. But how fight? By getting the insight to know that you are meant to work for me. Mai sarvani karmani. Dedicate all your work to me. Mai sanyasya matparaha. Offer all your work to me. Mai sarvani nirashir nirmamo bhutva. That become free from desire. Become free from possessive mentality. Become free from lethargy. Mai sarvani karmani sanyasya adhyatma chetasa. That become spiritually conscious. So what Krishna tells Arjuna is that vigata jvara, give up the influence of the mode of tamas, ignorance, that is lethargy. Give up the influence of the mode of rajas, of passion, that is asha and mamatva. I want to possess this. I want to enjoy this. And then, sarvani karma, sanyas adhyatma chetasa, come to the level of sattva, by actually understand yourself in spiritual. And ultimately, go beyond sattva to transcendence, understanding me to be the supreme transcendental reality, understanding me to be life's ultimate goal. So in this way, the Gita gives us sight of the inner world. So, Krishna tells Arjun to fight not because he has to take revenge against those who have wronged him. He has to fight because he's a soul whose eternal function is to serve Krishna. And in that particular situation, Arjun had to serve Krishna by helping Krishna help establish Dharma, by neutralizing those who were militantly opposed to Dharma. So thus, at the end of the Bhagavad Gita, the insight that Arjun has got, Arjuna is not saying, oh, those who have done so much atrocities against me, I'll kill them. He says, Krishna, I will do your will. So this insight, understanding that Krishna is our ultimate well-wisher, serving Krishna is our ultimate self-interest, this is what the Gita helps Arjuna to understand. That's why he says, Karishye vachinam tava. So for all of us, if we study the Gita will also give us similar insights. And that way, we can, by removing illusions within us, act most effectively in the outer world. Thank you. Hare Krishna.